Hi everyone, it's Louise with Louise Make Art, and I'm presenting today a theme from the sea with a collaboration between myself and my neighbor up the street who created a really cool ocean ship steering wheel themed clock. So here's the face portion that I created using the bloom technique, and then here is the final creation incorporating that face into the clock. And I'm going to voice over a lot of this because my heater is on again and it's drowning out a lot of what I'm saying. So I'm just going to go over it real quick. I'm going to share with you the colors. That happens to be Golden's Payne's Gray. I'm also going to pick up the pace here because you can see pretty clearly what I'm doing. The next color here is Golden's Iridescent Silver. This is DecoArt's Extreme Sheen Sky Blue Topaz. And then I've got my Golden's Iridescent Pearl. And last is my homemade blue mixture that it started out with Amsterdam's Bluish Green. And this is my American Floetrol Cell Activator recipe, and that happens to be video 141 if you want to take a look at how I create it. And the two colors of cell activator I'm laying down is the titanium white and then the oxide black, both by Amsterdam. So this cell activator is a little bit older, and plus that wasn't the most perfect blowout, so I'm using the straw to help conjure up the cells through the cell activator because it is thicker to start with. Now, as far as this creation goes, I had seen the framework for this clock beforehand, and it's kind of like a stainless steel. So I'm trying to have this color reflect that kind of feel of the ocean and the stainless steel color. The other thing, the face of that clock happened to come off and happens to have like four prongs and holes in it. So I had to tape up the back. Four holes, actually it was five holes when it was all said and done. So I would have taped the back anyway because I'm going to be resining this, but especially with the holes, definitely had to tape through the back. This was the first time I ever had this many holes in the face that I had to tape up. And I was a little worried about that, but actually in the end it worked out fine. Especially when you resin it, you can't even tell the difference. Everything lays flat. When I got done with the painting actually had little divots in it, but once you resin it, you can't even tell the difference. So if you're new to the channel, I often cut out when I'm cleaning up the turntable's top, just because you don't need to see me wasting time cleaning up. But just so you know, I do recycle my paints after I strain them out, and then I use them as a base again, or a pillow again, if you want to call it that. So here I'm just popping a few bubbles. So in the spin out, I've gotten a couple air bubbles that are coming through, so I'm just popping them, making sure that my paint's going to lay flat, and then I continue on spinning. Yeah, this creation was actually really pretty straightforward and simple. So cooperated really nicely, and I got a good result on the first try. So I'm just about done here, just cleaning up the sides a little bit, and I'll be showing you a sort of close-up in a second, and then I will show you the final result again. Thanks for tuning in, everybody. I hope you enjoyed the video. And if you haven't yet subscribed and liked the video and like to get more tutorials, please subscribe, hit the bell, and you'll get all my latest videos. I upload about 3 a week. Thanks a lot, everybody. Take care.